We call it three to see, two to flee, because we want to tell you where to go and where not to go. So I will start off with Gravity. I mean, there's no question about it. Again, big screen, a must on this one.
And it's absolutely, I mean, it's the film that everybody's going to want to see this weekend.
I hope so. Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs 2 is my second one in this. And that's a film that I think, it's always nice to see any film, however modest, exceed the original, and a film that has actual identifiable jokes, which is more than I can say of all three of the Ice Age movies, for example. And my third would be Enough Said, the Nicole Hofstetter film, which is giving us, unfortunately, James Gandolfini's second-to-last screen portrayal, co-starring with Julia Louis-Dreyfus, in a very satisfying, small-scale, and actually for adults sort of romance. So that's my three to see. Give me your three to see, and then we'll go to the fleas.
Well, all right. So three actually currently playing in town. Wadija is the first film made in Saudi Arabia, which does not have a film industry. It was made by a female director in a country where women aren't really allowed to speak to men. She actually had to direct it from a van whenever she was outside so she could give her her male stars instructions via remote control because she couldn't be seen to be giving men instructions in public.
Right.
And that's the environment it was made, but it's this very small, very beautiful story, largely about a woman and her daughter, and the daughter sort of growing up in this environment and wanting things that it's not appropriate for her to want, like a bicycle and freedom of expression. It's a beautifully directed, beautifully acted film.
Good. Yeah, good film.
So the second one would be In a World, which, have you seen that?
I love it.
It's a really, really cute little story about a girl, a young woman, Lake Bell, who also wrote and directed, who wants to be a voiceover artist in, again, this may be a theme with these, in an environment where that doesn't really happen. And she wants to take over for the In a World.
Yeah. In fact, I prefer that film to Enough Said, In a World, so I'm glad you mentioned that. So what's
your third? A lot of fun. My third is Poltergeist is actually playing at the Logan Theater in town.
Right.
So, you know, there's been such a spate of haunting movies and possession movies going on right now. It's kind of nice to have a chance to see on the big screen, like one of the films that's sort of like at the heart
of that. With a crowd.
Exactly. Right, see it in a crowd. See it with somebody that you want to like clutch in terror.
Good. Quickly, my two to flee, Parkland, which opens this Friday. It should have been a good film. It's a fact-based account of the Parkland Hospital trauma center docs and nurses who tried to save President Kennedy after the assassination in 1963. Also tried to save Lee Harvey Oswald in a related shooting. Even if you don't agree with the film's sort of tacit dismissal of every possible conspiracy theory, it's just flat as drama. And my second to flee, it's old news, summer film. But Planes, I don't care if you see it in Disney's Planes in 3D, 2D, 1D, 4D, it's got no D for me. Will you?
Well, what it's completely, completely D-list for me. That was also on my list of two to flee. Now that Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs 2 is in theaters, there's no excuse.
Why?
There's no excuse to go see Planes, which is just lesser animation, lesser story, lesser emotion, lesser fun. Go see the good one.
So what's your other flee?
My other flee is this movie called All is Bright, which is... debuted on VOD like a month ago, and now it's suddenly in theaters. It's Paul Giamatti and Paul Rudd in this sort of road movie, mismatched buddy comedy, Christmas movie about a couple of Canadians coming to New York City to sell Christmas trees.
Right.
And it's kind of this miserablest film that it maybe is masquerading as a drama, maybe as a comedy, but it's not really either, and it's really not fun.
You're telling me the title's lying? All is Bright?
All really isn't all right. Bright.
I'm
They're great actors, not a good movie.
Okay. You can't do anything about the material?